As long as I can remember, I've wanted to be a pro surfer from competing at a really young age. It was always my dream to be world champion, as it is with any kid, but I've been lucky over the years that my career has transformed into something a little more laid back. It's pretty cool that my childhood dreams have come to fruition in a little different way than I'd imagined. I live in Hana, Maui, part of the time, California, San Diego, part of the time. I'm a professional surfer and farmer, slash. I don't know if I want to claim that I'm a farmer, I'm really not. The house I grew up in was great. We had gigantic mango trees, avocado trees, banana trees. My dad had a really big garden in the backyard. We were really close to the beach, so I was either playing in the yard or out in the water from a very young age. In June, you'll be skipping like stone. Back out on the road with all your summer friends. In June, you'll be making love with the sun like you always done, like you always will. Boys ain't your thing. Can't say that I blame you. All I have is what I bring. I ain't one to beg you. I ain't one to shame you. I know February is my only chance to win you back again, keep you from the cold. And I know, oh, when frost comes creeping in, all this desert sand will feel like some old. Yeah, my friends and I grew up with the jungle as our backyard, jumping off cliffs into the water, surfing, diving. From day one, I've had a deep appreciation for being able to grow my own food. And my dad set me up at the fruit stand out front on the road in front of our house, where I would put bananas and mangoes and papayas and make bouquets, sell flowers to tourists. And I'd save up money to buy surfboards. That's what I did. It was just the way of life, how my friends and I, we all grew up. Malia and I met a long time ago. My sister and her went to school together.
I started going to Hana with Hank and his sister and just completely fell in love with it. It was more rural than even where I grew up, and people had a deep appreciation for community, for nature, for growing their own food. It was everything that I had experienced growing up and all that I wanted to.
We always had a really nice, easy connection. We'd talk for hours, and she was always really interesting to me, and eventually we fell in love and we were basically best friends at that point. Farming and nature was something we connected on. We were both really passionate about getting out in the wild and also into growing our own food and foraging.
So I definitely always had an appreciation for nature and plants. We grew a lot of our own food. Coming to Hana, I think, showed me the extent to which one could do that and that you could make almost a full-time job finding your own food, growing it.
I've always been really proud of my yard and garden, so when Malia started coming around, I would show her and she would show that equal enthusiasm, and it was just a really special thing to be able to share with a friend.
I always envied that he spearfished and would dive, and that was something I would have loved to do growing up, but never quite got fully introduced to it. And so I started doing that with Hank little by little, and it was so much fun. He made me my first gun, spear gun, and fell in love with it.
I hate the morning for every possible reason, except for the chance I get to try again. I say I was betrayed by the kindest season. No, but autumn, I don't believe a word they said. Find me, oh, I'll be staring at the star. Not trying to name her, not trying to blame her. Ain't got no judgment.
So I got accepted to school in San Diego, and Hank decided to move there, kind of be base for surf stuff out of San Diego, and also spend a little more time with me, since it'd be hard for me to come back to Hawaii while I was in physical therapy school. It's year round.
We didn't want to do long distance again, so when she got accepted to physical therapy school, I moved along with her.
I wasn't sure about the idea of Hank moving to San Diego. You know, Hank comes from a place that's just so pure, such a tight group of friends. It's almost like everybody goes everywhere together rather than separating at night. I didn't know how he would do with that in California, and if he could be as happy as he is in Hana.
We're lucky to live two blocks from the ocean. That's been a really nice escape of everyday life in the city. Everybody's crazy busy here, whereas growing up in Hana, the pace is just slow motion compared to this.
I'm a little surprised at some of the excitement he gets out of things like going to LA, or like figuring out that Mexico is so close, just things like that. He's really, I think, made the best out of it, and that definitely has impressed me.
Yes, it's true, I built this house. Yes, it's true, she once was mine. Yes, it's true, I disappeared on a cold spring night. They say you've been hanging around, but you cannot settle in. Every morning you think I'm gonna be rolling around that bend. Oh, but I ain't coming back. No, I ain't coming back. When I'm gone, I'm gone. Child, believe that. No, I ain't coming back. Never care for your purgatorial town. Your little weed got everybody hiding underground. I search for your culture, I search for your community. You didn't want none of that. Show as hell didn't you want me. Also, I ain't coming back. No, I ain't coming back. Make yourself a homeboy, unpack your bag. So I ain't.
In California, we are able to have this little garden, and we, you know, you don't need much land, and you can just have this teeny little piece. And
although it's not a 2-acre property with the jungle and the ocean surrounding it, just having the small space we have for a garden is, you get that same feeling getting your hands in the dirt and eating the food that you've grown. It's good for the soul.
It was perfect to have Hank there living with me, who is just so down for adventures and passionate about keeping our lives the way that we grew up and keeping everything so in line with just how we would like to live. Because I think it's easy to get taken away by a busy life and forget about those things that you used to love to do when you were younger.
No, I ain't coming back. Oh, I ain't coming back.
as we've traveled and as we've lived over other places, we've been able to see how little it takes to at least partially sustain yourself. And so that's inspiring. I think that's prolonged my time out of Hawaii.
Growing up in Hawaii, we've always had a really strong sense of community. That's something I've kind of taken upon myself to really bring here.
Hank pretty quickly found a group of friends, some of them being from Hawaii, but we had a good crew in San Diego. Hank really took it upon himself to make a point of having barbecues and dinner parties and kind of the same style that we would have in Hana, just a little more like he was the one instigating it. So it was beautiful to watch him almost force the issue of having a community in California, and then it really sprouted from that. Even though Hawaii has my favorite things in the world, I love that we've been able to move and come to California, and I feel like it keeps you with a fresh, open mind and keeps you meeting new people who you've never thought that could be so close, part of your community.
My whole life, I felt a really strong connection with nature, and I didn't want to lose that moving to the city. So I surf, I dive, work in the garden. Yeah, being in San Diego has really taught me that no matter where you're at in the world, it's possible to live the life you desire.